Self-Service Disability Compensation Claims Tool at VA.gov. Section 1, Veteran Profile. Welcome to the new Self-Service Disability Compensation Claims Tool demonstration. These easy-to-follow video tutorials will focus on specific sections of the application so that you can more easily reference the parts you need later. In Section 1, we'll describe the Self-Service Claims Tool and outline the first section of the application process, including logging in and locating the Disability Claims Self-Service Tool, verifying veteran identity and service history, the intent to file date, and indicating if an already rated veteran condition is worse. The Self-Service Claims Tool makes it easier for veterans to submit their claims online. It also enhances efficiency of processing and reduces administrative burden for VA adjudicators who process benefits compensation claims. It allows veterans to register an intent to file date, file for benefits due to service-related conditions, submit claims for new conditions, secondary conditions, and claims for increase, and direct VA where to retrieve records about those conditions. This Self-Service Claims Tool provides a digital representation of VA Form 21-526EZ, the March 2018 version, as well as VA Forms 21-0781, 0781A, 4142, and 4142A. Previously, veterans have been able to request an increase of disability compensation on VA.gov. This existing link to request an increase in compensation will remain on the site for veterans who only want to file for increased benefits on an existing service-connected condition. This new, full-featured self-service claim tool is available to veterans who have previously filed a claim for disability compensation benefits. To file a claim, veterans must first sign in by clicking on the Sign In button at the top of the screen. As you can see on the sign-in panel, there are three ways to sign in: DS Logon, same as eBenefits, My Healthy Vet Premium, or ID.me. The newest sign-in option, ID.me, uses two-factor authentication for verifying credentials and allows for easy registration. After signing in, the veteran goes to the File a Claim for Compensation link underneath the Disability section on the VA.gov homepage. This pulls up the How to File a VA Disability Claim page. The veteran can then scroll down to the heading How Do I File My Claim and click the File a Disability Compensation Claim button underneath it. This brings up a series of questions for the veteran to answer. First, the self-service tool asks the veteran if they have separated from their military or uniform service. If they answer no, a message will pop up that informs them they need to file a claim on and use eBenefits. If the veteran answers yes, they will proceed to the next question. The second question asks if this is the first time the veteran is filing a disability claim with VA. If the answer is yes, the tool advises the veteran they must file their claim on eBenefits. If the veteran answers no, they move on to a third question. This third question asks the veteran if they are filing a new claim or disagreeing with a VA decision on an earlier claim. If they are disagreeing with a VA decision, the tool asks for the official date of VA's decision and provides instructions on how to file an appeal. If they indicate they are filing a claim for a new or worsening condition, the tool provides a link to proceed to file a disability compensation claim. Following this link brings up the File for Disability Compensation page. The veteran is presented with two buttons to either start the disability compensation application or continue your application if one already exists. In this example, we'll click the Continue button. This opens a page that shows the veteran's intent to file expiration date. In this example, the veteran has an ITF that expires on February 8, 2020. At this point, the veteran has started the application process and has an intent to file date. From the Intent to File page, the next step is to select Continue to answer questions that will populate the Apply for Disability Compensation form. As veterans move through the self-service tool, they can return to previous information areas or sections by selecting the Back button and move forward through the form using the Continue button. The next step is to confirm basic identity information: name, date of birth, and gender. Once the veteran verifies the identity information, they click the Continue button to move on. The veteran then specifies what type of disability claim they're filing, such as a claim for a new condition, and to specify if one or more of their rating conditions have worsened. Our sample veteran has chosen to file for both a new condition and a worsening of a previously rated condition. They click the Continue button to proceed. Next, the veteran must address military service history and what VA has on file. As you can see on the screen, our sample veteran already has 2 periods of service as a member of the Army from May 3, 1952 to June 12, 1970, and as a member of the Army Reserve from February 4, 1971 to June 26, 1980. They can edit this information by clicking the Edit button to the right, or add more service information by clicking the Add Another Service Period button underneath the existing record. If the veteran enters a service period that extends past September 11, 2001, the tool will next ask if they served in a combat zone after this date. If the veteran has posted a period of service as a member of the reserve, they are prompted to provide additional details about this service, such as their obligation start date, obligation end date, and unit name. Finally, the veteran must indicate if they are currently activated on federal orders in the reserves or the National Guard. Our veteran has selected no for this application. This completes Section 1 of the new Interactive Disability Claims process, where we learned how to enter or identify an intent to file and how to review and/or edit veteran ID information. In Section 2, we'll detail how veterans can add and claim new conditions for disability compensation benefits. The new self-service disability compensation tool is located at www.va.gov/disability/how-2-file-claim.